लिसन केयरफुली अबाउट इट। वर्किंग कैपिटल टर्न ओवर रेशियो, ये चिल्ड्रन दिस इज वन मोर एक्टिविटी रेशियो एंड वी नो दैट द पर्पज ऑफ एक्टिविटी रेशियो इज टू चेक ऑपरेशनल एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द बिजनेस। व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ वर्किंग कैपिटल टर्नओवर रेशियो? इट इज वेरी सिंपल। टर्नओवर मींस सेल्स, मींस नेट सेल्स, मींस रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन। रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशंस एंड अपॉन वर्किंग कैपिटल। ओके, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट वर्किंग कैपिटल? वर्किंग कैपिटल इज इक्वल टू करंट एसेट्स माइनस करंट लाइबिलिटीज, एज वी नो, है ना। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस रेशियो? द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस रेशियो इज दैट हाउ मच वर्किंग कैपिटल is employed in the business to generate this much sales. So more the ratio, better the condition. More the ratio means working capital is less and the efficiency of business is very good, that with less working capital business is able to generate very good amount of sales. So remember dear children, this is one more thing: more the ratio, better the condition, in this case working capital turnover ratio. So let's begin with the numerical. Let's solve some numericals. Question number 105. Working capital turnover ratio, question number 105. Calculate working capital turnover ratio from the following information. Revenue from operation is given directly 24 lakh. Current assets and current liabilities are given. Okay, so we can easily calculate working capital turnover ratio. Just a minute. Okay, so let's start. Working capital turnover ratio means revenue from operation upon working capital. Now revenue from operation is given in the question. It is given 24 lakh. So we can write directly 24 lakh. And we need to calculate working capital. The formula of working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. Current asset is given 10 lakh, current liability is given 4 lakh. So 10 lakh minus 4 lakh is equal to 6 lakh. Let us put this 6 lakh in the formula. 6 lakh, and when we divide 24 by 6, what we get? 6, 4 is 24, 4 times. One more thing, we express working capital turnover ratio in times, you know? So 4 times, it means 6 lakh rupees working capital is needed to generate 24 lakh rupees sales, you know? I hope this is clear to everyone. Let's solve one more question. 106. Question number 106. From the following information, calculate working capital turnover ratio. Now children, in this question, cost of goods sold is given. Cost of revenue from operation is given 5 lakh. Current asset and current liabilities are given. So from current asset and current liability, we can calculate working capital. But by any way, we are not able to calculate revenue from operation. In this condition, cost of goods sold will be taken, hai na? Working capital turnover ratio means revenue from operation upon working capital. Now in this question, we have seen that cost of goods sold is given in place of revenue from operation. But it is also possible that goods can be sold at cost of goods sold, yes or no? There are some conditions that goods can be sold at loss also, for no profit, no loss, or at loss also sometimes. And no information is given, there is no way to calculate revenue from operation. So that's why we will use cost of goods sold here, which is given here. Right? So it will be 5 lakh. Only in these type of exceptional cases. And current assets minus current liabilities, working capital. So 2 lakh 50 minus 1 lakh 50 is equal to 1 lakh. So it will be 5 times. I hope it is clear. Okay, let's move on next. Next question. Question number 107. Revenue from operation under this cash sales, credit sales and sales return is given. Okay, we need revenue from operation. Revenue from operation means net sales, and net sales means the sales in which sales return is deducted. Children, remember this point. Huh? So let's calculate revenue from operation. First, in this question, revenue from operation, how to calculate? Cash sales is given 5 lakh. Cash sales is given 5 lakh. Add credit sales. What we get when we add cash sales plus credit sales? Total sales 6 lakh. 5 plus 6, 11 lakh. This is total sales. And when we subtract sales return, how much sales return is given? 1 lakh. When we subtract sales return, then we get net sales. So net sales is 10 lakh. Okay. So this is what which is required. This is revenue from operation, means net sales. Okay. Now we need working capital also. Working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. So we can calculate here 3 minus 1, 2 lakh. Hai na? So working capital turnover ratio, working capital turnover ratio is equal to revenue from operation upon working capital. Revenue from operation is computed 10 lakh, and working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. Current assets 3 lakh, current liabilities 1 lakh, 3 minus 1, 2 lakh. 10 lakh divided by 2 lakh, 5 times. Working capital turnover ratio is 5 times. I hope it is clear. Okay, so let's move on another question. Question number 108. Question number 108. Equity share capital is given 15 lakh. Gross profit on revenue from operation is 33.33, we can say, percent, hai na? What is given? Gross profit is given 33.3% or 0.33% on sales. Cost of revenue from operation is given 20 lakh. Cost of goods sold is given 20 lakh. Current assets 10 lakh. Okay. Current assets is given 10 lakh. And current liabilities are given 2,50,000. So here only we can calculate working capital. Current assets minus current liability is equal to working capital. 10 lakh minus 2,50,000, 7,50,000 is working capital we have computed. What to do? We need to calculate working capital turnover ratio. So working capital turnover ratio means we need revenue from operation upon working capital. Working capital is given. Revenue from operation is required, which we can calculate by using gross profit on sales and by using COGS. One more information which is given here, equity share capital, it is not required in this question, because we can calculate RFO without it also. So as we know that sales minus profit is equal to cost of goods sold. So suppose sales is X. If sales is X, profit will be 33%. 33% means 1/3. Yes or no? 1/3 means 1/3 or 100/3. So it means profit will be x/3, 33% of sales is equal to cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold is given 20 lakh. Now let us solve this equation. X minus x/3, what we get? When we take LCM, we get 2x/3 is equal to 20 lakh. Yes or no? And when we cross multiply, X is equal to 3 multiply by 20 lakh divide by 2. 2 1 2, 10 lakh into 3, 30 lakh, means X is equal to 30 lakh. And what is X? Your net sales. So we have computed net sales, revenue from operation 30 lakhs. So I am writing in place of RFO upon working capital. Working capital is 7,50,000. 7,50,000. So 30 lakh divided by 7,50,000 four times. I hope it is clear to everyone. Can we move on next?
Yes.
Okay. So let's solve question number 109. Question number 109. Gross profit is given 25% on cost. Okay. So gross profit is 25% on cost. It is given, this information is given. Gross profit is also given 5 lakh. Gross profit is given 5 lakh. Equity share capital is given 10 lakh. Okay. Reserve and surplus is given. Okay. Equity share capital is given 10 lakh. Reserves and surplus 2 lakh. Long-term loan 3 lakh. Long term loan is given 3 lakh. Fixed assets given 10 lakh. Okay. Fixed assets given 10 lakh. Calculate working capital turnover ratio. Okay. We need to calculate working capital turnover ratio. And the formula of working capital turnover ratio is revenue from operation upon working capital. And both these values are not given. So with this given information, gross profit is 5 lakh and gross profit is 25% on cost, we can calculate रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन. ओके, ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 25% ऑन कॉस्ट एंड ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज गिवन 5 लाख. एंड वी नो डियर चिल्ड्रन दैट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड प्लस प्रॉफिट इज इक्वल टू सेल्स. यस और नो? And gross profit is given 25% on cost. It means if COGS is 100, profit will be 25%. It is mentioned here 25% on cost. So if cost is 100, profit will be 100 and sales will be 125. Yes or no? And in this question, profit is given, 25 is given, how much? 5 lakh. What to calculate? Sales we need to calculate, है ना? So if 25 is 500, what is 125? We can solve very easily by cross multiplication, dear children. So we can calculate sales here by this simple equation, है ना? So x is equal to 5 lakh multiply by 125 divide by 25. So 25 5 जा 125. And 5 5 25, it means 25 lakh. So revenue from operation we have computed 25 lakh. One thing we have computed. Now we need working capital. Now you can see with this given information, equity share capital, reserve and surplus, and long term loan, these three are liability. Yes or no? So when we add these liabilities, what we get? 15 lakh. So total liabilities, this is total liability, है ना? Total liability is 15 lakh and only fixed assets are given. So total liabilities minus fixed assets 10 lakh, what we get? Total liabilities means total assets, yes or no? Total liabilities means total assets. So 15 lakh minus 10 lakh fixed assets, 15 lakh minus 10 lakh, what is remaining? 5 lakh. That is your current asset. That is your current asset, है ना? And what is the formula of working capital? The formula of working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. Working capital is equal to current assets 5 lakh. And in this question, current liability is not given, है ना? It means working capital is equal to 5 lakh. I hope it is clear to everyone. This system is clear to everyone, right? So working capital is 5 lakh, which we can put in the formula, right? So working capital turnover ratio is equal to RFO 25 lakh divide by working capital 5 lakh. 25 by 5 is equal to 5 times. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, so capital employed is given 12 lakh. Net fixed assets are given 8 lakh. Net fixed assets are given 8 lakh. Cost of goods sold is given 40 lakh. Okay. And gross profit is 20% on cost. 20% on cost means 20% of COGS. So 20% of 40 lakh is 4 to 8, 8 lakh, yes or no? And COGS plus gross profit is equal to sales, hai na? So 40 plus 8, 48 lakh. So your revenue from operation, your net sales is computed here only, hai na? Calculate working capital turnover ratio. Working capital turnover ratio means RFO is required and we have computed. upon working capital. Now children, again in this question you can see capital employed is given. Capital employed means shareholder fund plus non-current liability. Okay dear children, it means total liability is given 12 lakh and only fixed assets are given 8 lakh. It means total liability minus fixed assets is equal to current assets, hai na? So we can calculate in this manner very easily. Capital employed, total liabilities, under total liability only capital employed is given, hai na? Current liability is not given. It is given 12 lakh total liabilities, and total liabilities are equal to total assets as we know, hai na? When we subtract net fixed assets, we get 4 lakh rupees. What is this 4 lakh? Current assets, hai na? Total assets minus fixed assets is equal to current assets. And then we have formula of working capital, that is current asset minus current liabilities. Current liability is not given in the question, so working capital will be 4 lakh minus nil, that is 4 lakh. So working capital will be 4 lakh. Okay, so working capital is 4 lakh and RFO is 48 lakh. So let us put 48 lakh divide by 4 lakh. So 4, 12 ja 48, 4 1 ja 4, 4 2 ja 8, hai na? So working capital turnover ratio is 12 times. I hope it is clear to everyone. 111. Okay. Question number 111. Calculate working capital turnover ratio from the following information. RFO is given 15 lakh. Revenue from operation is given 15 lakh. Current assets given 6,25,000. Current asset is given 6,25,000. Total assets are given 10 lakh. Okay. Total assets are given 10 lakh. Non-current liabilities are given 5 lakh. Non-current liabilities are given 5 lakh. Shareholder funds are given 2,50,000. Shareholder funds are given 2,50,000. Calculate working capital turnover ratio. Okay. So to calculate working capital turnover ratio, we need RFO, revenue from operation. And children, revenue from operation is already given 15 lakh. Upon working capital, to calculate working capital we need current assets given and current liabilities which is not given. So in this question you can see total assets are given, yes or no? Total assets are equal to total liabilities, everybody know. Total assets are equal to total liabilities. So it is given 10 lakh. It means total liability is 10 lakh. From total liability if we subtract shareholder fund and non-current liability, so what we get? We get current liabilities, yes or no? 5 lakh shareholder fund is given. Shareholder fund is given 2,50,000. And non-current liability is given 5 lakh. So when we subtract 7,50,000 from total liability, we get current liability 2,50,000. So in this manner we have computed current liability. We have current assets, so we can easily calculate working capital. Working capital means current assets minus current liability, है ना? And working capital is equal to current assets are given in the question 6,25,000. So 6,25,000 minus current liability 2,50,000, है ना? Let's subtract. So 6,25,000 minus 2,00,000, 4,25,000, 4,25,000 minus 50, 3,75,000. Yes or no? So 3,75,000 is our working capital. Let's put in the formula. Revenue from operation is given 15,00,000. Revenue from operation 15,00,000 upon working capital 3,75,000. So 3 4 12 and 75 4 3 lakh means 4 times. Yes or no? So I hope it is clear to everyone. So let's solve one more question. Question number 112. Yes. Let's start. A company earns gross profit of 25% on cost. So gross profit is 25% on cost. For the year ended 31st March 17, its gross profit was 5,00,000. Okay. And gross profit is given 5,00,000. Okay. Equity share capital of the company is 10,00,000. Equity share capital is given 10,00,000. Reserves and surplus given 2,00,000. Reserve and surplus is given 2,00,000. Long term loan is given 3,00,000. Only these many liabilities are given, है ना? Okay. So when we add these three liabilities, these are liabilities 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 15,00,000 total liabilities are given. And we know that total liability is equal to total assets. Yes or no? And non-current assets are given 10,00,000. When we subtract non-current assets, total assets minus non-current assets, how much it is given? 10,00,000. Non-current assets are given 10,00,000. When we subtract 10,00,000, what we get? 5,00,000. So what is 5,00,000? 5,00,000 is our current asset. So remember this, how I have computed current assets, है ना? So current liability is not given in the question. We need to calculate working capital turnover ratio. So we need revenue from operation upon working capital. So first I will calculate revenue from operation, है ना? Gross profit is 25% on cost. So gross profit is equal to 25% on cost. So whatever is the cost, 25% of it will be gross profit. Na? I think it is more simple for all of you. Gross profit is 25% on cost. But gross profit is given how much? 5,00,000. So by this equation, we can calculate cost of goods sold into 25 upon 100. Yes or no? Can we solve it? Very easily we can solve it. So it will be COGS means our cost of goods sold is equal to 5,00,000 multiply by 100 divide by 25. 25 4 ja 5 4 ja 20. So cost is 20 lakh, profit is 5 lakh, and cost plus profit is equal to RFO. Revenue from operation is equal to COGS plus profit, है ना? So RFO will be 20 lakh plus profit 5 lakh is equal to 25 lakh. So RFO is 25 lakh, it is computed. So we can write RFO 25 lakh. Now we need working capital, only current assets is given. We can calculate working capital is equal to current assets minus current liabilities. Only current asset is given, working capital 5 lakh, current liability is not given, hai na? So working capital will be 5 lakh. Yes or no? So 5 lakh working capital, and when we divide 25 by 5, what we get? We get 5 times. Yes, dear children. So I hope the question is clear to everyone.